Welcome to this edition of Influence Living. I'm your host, Wade, and here on Influence Living, we love to travel around the world and ask individuals, what has influenced your life? You know, have you ever noticed that some people, even though life can be chaotic around them, the economy can be collapsing and things can be going on, they're still just steady? Nothing seems to shake them? Why is that? What is influencing people like that? Well, we've got three such people right here on today's edition of Influence Living. The first person we're going to talk to is a fellow by the name of Sasson. Now, Sasson served in the Israeli Defense Force and certainly has gone through some things in his life and a lot of trouble that he's gone through, but something has kept him steady. He saw something, a vision that changed his life. He's going to tell you his story right now.
I grew up in a Messianic family. From a small age, I was born in Ukraine. We moved here when I was a few months old, so all my life I've been here in Israel, so I am Israeli. Even though I grew up in a Messianic family, I was not exactly a believer. I was going to school, to high school. I was shameful from being a Messianic. In my culture, to believe in Jesus, it's like to betray your own people. And so I was not sharing with my friends that I am a Messianic, so I would live the same way they would live. I used to smoke, I used to do a lot of troubles, a lot of stupid things, but I always knew who I am, but it was really hard to keep it open to others. I was ashamed of him, but at the same time I knew that he is the way, even though I was living not as a believer. And it's been a long process to get to a point that I understood. When I was 17, I was flying to youth camp in Greece. And it actually, that was a point that kind of changed my way of thinking. And I really experienced there Jesus. And when I was praying one of the nights, I really seen his face and I seen him just going among the young people there. And that was one of the signs that, wow, he is real, he is alive. And when I came back to my senior year, I kind of started to be more open with my faith. I was still not speaking about it, but at least I felt that I'm getting more open with that. In age of 18, when I finished, when I graduated high school, I drafted to the army. And the army, it was a point of my life that I said, that's it. I'm not gonna be ashamed of the gospel, but I'm gonna share with everyone. I'm gonna preach everywhere, and I'm gonna say that I'm proud to be a believer in Jesus, to be a follower of Jesus. So in that moment, I kind of found my identity in him. And everywhere I was going, I would speak to the soldiers, to my friends, sharing with them my faith, who I am, and what I believe in. And it was nice even to hear from them, because I showed them that I didn't lost my Jewish identity, that I am a Jewish. I'm celebrating all the feasts. I'm doing the same thing as them, but at the same time, I believe that Jesus is the Messiah and he's the Savior. And that's the thing that we changed it. During my service in 2014, there was an operation in Gaza for 67 days. Unfortunately, I was not inside, but I was just on the border to help the soldiers, the wounded, and just to help as much as I can. Unfortunately, I lost two of my friends there, that operation. And you know, for a believer to be in the army, it's not so easy, especially if there is hatreds with the both sides. But of course, I knew that behind all these things, there is a spiritual sides. And I knew that our war is not against flesh and blood, but it's against spiritual war. It was really hard after I lost my friends just still to show the love of God, even though it really hard because I had to break my character and still say, you know what, I still love you, it doesn't matter what. And I'm speaking about the other side, about the Palestinian in Gaza. So that operation really changed my life and the way I think about life. And I had a few cases when I came home and I almost died twice from the rockets that fell right close to me, but God really protect me. When I finished the army, I felt that I need to take a year off from everything just to get away. So I fly to Sweden to study in Bible College, just to kind of to be fresh in the spirit and just have a good time. And that year was amazing for me. It was just the best thing I did because I had a lot of a bottle inside of me. Should I go, should I not, should I stay? But God spoke to me, said to me, you should go there. And in that year, I had a lot of time just to be me and God alone, just this intimacy to be one-on-one. And it changed my life too. And it put so much of desires in my heart, especially to work with young people, especially to show the light of God in the nations and of course in my nation. And today that's what I'm doing and that's what I'm trying to do, and just to be a real follower of Jesus. And how we do it is actually with being a light of God and show His love. Because I think with love you can do everything when you have His love in your heart. So yeah, that year after I finished it, I came back home. I met my wife 10 years ago, but we grew up together, but we never had anything. But God showed me that she is the one for me. And then God spoke to me to start to work with youth. And God is opening doors to fly to countries to share the true news about Israel. And that's what I'm doing today. So it's really amazing to see the change that God did in my life and how He changed everything from being that to get to that point. From being shameful from the gospel to be proud of the gospel, and from being lost to be found in His hands.
Assassin's story is certainly interesting, isn't it? A member of the IDF, and as a young man, he believed that Jesus is Messiah, and certainly that caused him some problems because in that part of the world, some people that believe that way aren't very well accepted. He saw a vision of Jesus, and he believes, and I believe, and he's experienced that Jesus Christ is God. And there's only one way to God the Father, and that is through Jesus Christ. That's what Jesus said. Actually, Jesus said, I'm the way, the truth, and the life, and nobody comes to the Father except through me. So either Jesus was lying, or he's telling the truth. Some people say that Jesus was a good prophet, but the problem is a good prophet doesn't claim to be God unless he is. Jesus says that you could come to God the Father through him. Sasson made a decision to receive Christ into his life, and he would have prayed a simple prayer, would have simply said this to God, and you can do this right now. You can just say this to God. Even if there's other people around, say it in your heart to God. You don't even have to say it out loud, but you've got to believe in your heart that Jesus is Messiah, that Jesus is God. And come on and say this with me. This is what Sasson would have done. He would have just said something like this to God. It's a prayer. It's communication to God. And you just say, God, I believe in you. I believe in Jesus. I ask Jesus to forgive me of my sins. And I invite you, God, into my life. I give you my life, whatever that means. In your name I pray. Amen. At Influence Living, we want to say congratulations. You just made a decision, the best decision of your life. Now begin to grow up in your faith. Find a Christian Bible. Begin to read in the book of John and find out who Jesus is. Talk to God on a daily basis. He calls us His friend if we have relationship with Him, and you've just opened that door to relationship. And then also, if you would, find a local Christian church and ask them to grow you up in your faith. Tell them you've decided to believe in Jesus as Savior, as Messiah, as God. You've made that decision. Ask them to help you as you grow up in your faith. If they don't, find another church that will. Ask them to assist you in that. We're so proud of you here at Influence Living. If you made that decision, we would love to hear about it. You see the details right there on your screen. There's our mailing address here in Orlando, Florida. You can just send us a standard mail letter if you'd like to, or shoot us an email at wade@influenceliving.com. That email address again is wade@influenceliving.com, or instant message us on Facebook. You see there, if you go to Influence Living on Facebook, you can catch up with us there. You can see other editions of Influence Living as well, and hear some other great influence stories. We would love to see you do that. One more thing before we go to the next segment here on Influence Living. Men, if you're interested in a daily devotional for 39 days, then I've got a book for you. It's called 39 Stripes. I wrote it recently. You can go onto Amazon, $9 US. You can pick it up and they'll ship it to you. They would love to put it in your hands. Just go to Amazon and purchase that book, 39 Stripes. Well, up next here on Influence Living, we're going to meet a young lady by the name of Christine. Now, Christine was raised to know God and around a church. However, she ran from God. but God caught up with her. Here's her story.